What are higher dimensions? You see versions of them in Interstellar and Stranger Things, these places where characters can travel through time or instantly appear somewhere else. But in mathematics, dimensions are real things. Physics has their own version, and then you have the entertainment industry. I'm Ashley Christine, and here's how it works. In mathematics, a dimension is a measurement of space. How big is a thing? A line segment is point A to point B, which is length. That is one unit of measurement, one dimensional. A square is two-dimensional, or 2D, and so has two units of measurement, length, and height. And my paper box here, which I folded myself because I learned how to do this when I was 9 years old, and it's a memory that refuses to let me go. This is three-dimensional because we have three units of measurement, length, height, and now width. This has thickness. So what is this squiggly line? Mathematicians spend a lot of time thinking about shapes, and if we're going to talk about dimensions, you'll want to start thinking a bit like that. A line is a word we use very liberally in language, and that's okay, but a line does have a specific definition. It is a one-dimensional figure that extends forever in opposite directions. Forever. A line segment is a piece of that. So yellow lines on a highway are line segments. The lines of this piece of paper, also segments. They have endpoints, which is why when we measure them, we get length. There are also rays, which have a starting point but no endpoint, like the sun, which is why we don't call them sun lines, we call them sun rays. This squiggly line is one-dimensional. You might have guessed two-dimensional because it's kind of got like a shape, but it has endpoints, so its only dimension is length. If you wanted to think like a mathematician and say, well, if the line is drawn on Earth and the Earth is curved, don't. Then eventually the line touches because the Earth is curved, and yes, now the line segment would become a circle, so it's two-dimensional. Maybe you're wondering now if a line is just about perspective. What about gravity or black holes tugging on it? Is it relative? From whose perspective is the line straight? Or if the universe collapses, wouldn't the line have endpoints? Welcome to the existential crisis of learning new questions to keep yourself up at night. How dimensions are connected can help you visualize this. A zero-dimensional object, for example, is a point. It has no length, no height, no volume, nothing to measure it with. It's just a location. When you connect two points, you get a line segment. Connecting them brought us up to one dimension. When you connect line segments, you get squares and triangles, and now we're at two dimensions. Connecting six squares, for example, and you get a cube. Three dimensions. Connecting lower dimensions can give you a higher dimensional object. Don't get ahead of yourself thinking you just solved higher dimensional travel, because the angle you do it matters and time comes into play, and that's when things get a bit weird. These circles are all the same and two-dimensional. To be fair, we don't use the dimensions of height and length on circles because they don't have straight lines, so we use things like radius and pi. But like a square, the circles have no depth, no thickness. They are still two-dimensional. To find the area of a circle, you multiply pi by the radius squared. Super simple. Combine four of these circles and you get a sphere, or a ball. So the surface area of a sphere is 4 times pi times radius squared. On paper, there is nothing stopping us from going higher and higher, but the math gets a bit more intimidating if you didn't take multivariable calculus, or usually Calc 3. Integrals. So where is all of it? I am a third-dimensional being, which is a step up from this two-dimensional circle. While I may be a dimension up, this circle is still in my space. We're both here. The difference is what I experience versus what it experiences. One of the best explanations I've ever seen of this, and the clip that inspired me to pursue mathematics, is Carl Sagan explaining it with an apple. How it works is I can easily interact with a lower dimension, but this circle can only interact or see certain parts of me. In this case, it is my finger, just this flat part here. The circle has no idea that the rest of my body exists because it can only experience what is in its dimension. It's like it can only see my shadow, which is the 2D version of my body. If I lift my finger then to the circle, I completely disappeared. But I didn't, did I? I just moved around in my own dimension. A lower dimensional object, like the circle, can't see that. In order for the circle to leave its world, it would have to take a 90 degree turn off its 2D plane. That puts it in a higher third dimensional world. Keep in mind that it doesn't mean the circle transforms into a sphere now. Its body didn't change. All that it's done is moved. Could I pull the circle out of its two-dimensional world? Sure. I can pick it up, move it around, and place it back down somewhere else in what will appear to be teleportation. This is how a tesseract works. Mathematically, these exist, but just because something checks on paper doesn't mean it works in the real world. Marvel was pretty clever in their description of a tesseract. They shaped it like a cube, and whatever character possesses it can immediately transport to other locations. It's okay if you're struggling to visualize higher dimensional objects, by the way. Pictures depicting these things are very misleading. We can't see a tesseract as it would truly exist because, for one, maybe they don't exist. But also, we are third-dimensional beings, and a tesseract is a four-dimensional cube. That means that all these corners should be 90 degrees, and every quadrilateral or flat plane that you see should be a square. Just like a circle needs to take a 90-degree turn up to leave its dimension, we would need to take a 90-degree turn out of this to leave our dimension. And that is something you've never seen before and probably will never be able to. So these images are just the best we can do for you. We've been talking about dimensions from the math perspective, which are spatial dimensions, so physical things only. But in physics, Einstein theorized that time is the fourth dimension. It's kind of like how Americans call this the first floor, but in Europe it's the ground floor, and this is the first floor, but in America that's the second floor. We probably should have just picked better words. A higher dimensional being can always interact with the lower dimensions because mathematically, we're built off of this. It's like being on the 10th floor of a building. You can't be there without also being on top of the first and fifth floors. And here's where movies like Interstellar can provide some helpful imagery. Interstellar did a great job of trying to visualize higher dimensions, where the main character is transported to a fifth spatial dimension, where he can pick any point in time in his daughter's bedroom to view the events at that time. Remember that the higher dimension can interact with the lower, so if time is the fourth dimension, and this character was brought up to the fifth dimension, then time would be a plane this character could comb through because it's beneath him, so to speak. Think of it like combing through a book, where this is time and I, the higher dimensional being, can skip ahead to the end here and watch the events unfold, or I can jump to the beginning. I can pick any point in time and watch it happen because I am, in this example, the fifth dimensional being, and this is the fourth. And that is essentially what happened in Interstellar. Unfortunately, there is no evidence of higher dimensions that we can physically go to. They may not exist at all. There is talk about dimensions being too small to see, or that higher dimensions are here and we have the shadows of them. String theory requires as many as 10 of them, or a black hole could lead to one. As a physical place to go to, it is still purely theoretical.